So we should be live. We're continuing with part two. Let's see if this actually works. It appears to work. Excellent. Okay. Let's see what these guys have to say. Oh, that's right. I gotta use this thing here. I don't want to waste too much time on this, but obviously I need to make a new league card. Let's go with Eevees, because I am a big Eevee fan. And then the effect. No. Fire? No. Let's give it that holographic look. There we go. And we'll put a nice little frame on it. More Eevees? Nah, that's too much Eevee. There we go. Now it looks like, oh, let's go the black bar on the gray bottom. There we go. That's what we're doing. To the next step. Okay. Let's change my expression. Show me what this looks like. Mouth open. This guy's chewing on something. Very surprised. This is actually pretty accurate, because when I smile, my eyes get all squinty. Nope. I need something happier looking. We're going with... yeah, that's the one. Change the pose. What do we got here? No. Maybe. No. Definitely not. Maybe. Yeah, that one. I'm stoked. Boom. Clear coating. Seems like the way to go. Print it! Important. People are going to be looking at this card when I become king of Pokemon. Let's see, we got plenty of Pokeballs, lots of potions. I think I'm okay with this. As I healed up last time. So, let's recap who our team is. Okay, got the full team. Let's go. Here we go. I'm here for the gym challenge. So, you're gonna walk me over here and then point to the gym, as if it weren't super obvious. Laters! Cool. Do I want to go straight there? Yep, I remember being able to hold products in my shop in actual stores pre-COVID. You got for me? You got some TMs? Oh, debating whether or not I should go back out to go back out into the wild area to train up some more. Maybe catch another Pokemon from one of the areas I haven't visited yet. That's pretty high level though. Oh, it's Charizard. There's Leon. Leon sounds like an idiot. Gets lost looking at the tallest building in the city. Feels like it moves way faster than would be safe for travel. Okay. Hop, I just get this feeling you're going to challenge me to another battle right now. Oh, thank goodness. I don't need him wasting my time right now. Give me a cool Pokeball. I said a cool Pokeball. You suck. Call him the ball guy. Another rival, he says as if he is one of my rivals. Give him our endorsements from Leon. This guy's gonna be like, what? Leon, for real? Well, I'm something special, and Hop is a nepotism thing. Nope. Okay, preferred uniform number. Let's go with this shouldn't be this challenging for me, but you know, this is the number I'm going to be for the whole game, you know? I'm going to go with number one. Number one for the now recently deceased Louis Nix, former Notre Dame football player. He just passed away a couple days ago. Okay. Check out them fancy digs, Hop. Hello. Morpico doesn't say oorah-rah. We will do our utmost. What is the matter with you? Endorsed by the chairman. Alright. Well, that is not a very nice thing to say. Yo, I'm one of the ones endorsed by the champ. Cool, cool, cool. That's me. I'm taking on the gym mission. I guess I have to go check in at the hotel first. Thank you for taking me to the hotel. Leave me alone. And Sonya's here. Hello, Sonya. We are registered. Thank you for noticing. Tell me about this statue, Sonya. Tell me the same story either way. The darkest day. The land was assaulted by gigantic Pokemon, but they were defeated by a single young hero. Bearing a sword and shield, this statue here is meant to depict the young hero of that legend. We still don't understand what kind of sword and shield the hero actually had. Except, it's pretty safe to guess, it's Zacian and Zamazenta. Spoilers. And what this black storm is supposed to be is just another mystery. Whatever it was, it blotted out the skies all across Galar. I suppose that tracks with being called the Darkest Day, but still.
I suppose that hero must have been about as strong as Lee, then.
I'll meet you, Hop. Looks like you're going to have your hands full with plenty to research this on. Yes, we should check in. Hello, I would like to check in. Let's move. So, in the grand scheme of all the teams in Pokemon history, Team Yell is among the weakest. I don't mean like in terms of their actual Pokemon strength. I mean like in terms of like quality of characters. Like they're just boring. And they're unnecessary. Already a problem here, because
needs to do in his dark time. Let's get him with the mud slap to lower that accuracy.
Boy, spinning the points a little early here, Paul.
So, you have to pick a, you have to say what your topic is for the haiku. Give me a topic, Paul. Okay. Mine is Caroline. Super smart, and she's cute too. Better than her dad. Done.
What do you think? Is that a good one? Also, I need to see, Paul, I need you to say something because I need to see if the chat box is working on my stream thing. I want it to show up on screen so that if people are watching it after the fact on YouTube or something. So now that should pop up on the screen any second now. If the chat box is working properly. Oh, there it is. Down at the bottom. And that's not going to work. Let me move that. I'm moving the chat box. I'll move chat box up here. And make it bigger. See if that's any better. But yes, excellent song by Tally Hall. Haiku. You are pathetic. Background behind that chat box just so that it's easier to see. We've been through this with Nicket before, also a dark type. Frustrating that I'm having psychic type out right now, but we'll hit him with the mud slap to make them less accurate. Hit on the mud slap. This Nicket doesn't know what it's looking at. Get him with the rock tune. Now I can finish it off with the mud slap. Miss. Yet another Team Yell grunt. Not used to that swanky, sophisticated air. Yes, thank you for healing my Pokemon. Also, would you give me an opportunity to switch one I'm using? No, I don't want to do a 2-on-2. Hop sucks. You guys gotta... Did y'all catch your Pokemon at the same time? Everybody's got the same Pokemon. Wooloo. Happy that there's a good chance that they're too low level to. Oh, I was wrong. I was gonna say too low level to have any dark attack. But what a mistake. I'm gonna switch Pokemon. Let's throw out my Teemy. Oh yeah, Paul. This is Team Yell. They're serious business. They're soccer hooligans, except for Pokemon. We'll finish off the Zigzagoon. Gotta be careful about leveling up Martini too much. I don't want him to get to the point where he is gonna ignore my commands. Good money. Thank you for the money. And we'll buy a couple of potions. Marnie! Gotta show restraint. Oh gosh, Paul, I have no idea. It's been ages. Because usually I just run through the gyms so quickly that I never even come close to the limits. But because I'm doing this Nuzlocke, I'm trying to kind of over-level a little bit before everything. Here to check in. You're quite welcome. Always happy to help with hooligans. Practicing his Pokeball throws again. What a goober. You have something to say. Nope. All right. Let's save. Please, escort me to the stadium. Thank you. How's my volume today, Paul? Am I too loud? Is the game too loud? Yeah. I always worry. You know, I'm trying to be consistent. Akbar, we don't want you to be first person out of the gate. Let's go ahead and swap. We'll start with Sir Peck. He's getting ready to level soon. Change, thanks. That number one really suits me. Get used to saying it. Get pumped, Paul. This is it, the opening ceremony. Now you watch this, Paul, and tell me that you don't want to play this game, for real. I mean, I know you want to play this game, but like, it's got to make you want to go out and get it right now. Chairman Rose, it might as well be David Beckham. The hair, the facial hair. Show yourselves, gym leaders. Welcome to the Hunger Games. Yeah, exactly. These are the gym leaders. Well, some of them are. Kabu gave me trouble last time, but this time I'm probably gonna have more trouble from the farmer guy. You know, the grass types versus Martini are gonna be trouble. So one of the differences between Sword and Shield, if you haven't played both or weren't aware, they don't have the same gym leaders. There's a couple that are different from game to game. So, like, I didn't have Gordy or B in the Shield version of the game. Here we go. Stepping out onto the pitch. We made it. What's up, Chairman Rose? Yes, we do. Pokemon Tony Stark invented the Dynamax bands. Thank you. Always about business, Chairman Rose. You gotta slow down and smell the Roselia. Although, honestly, that's weird, if you think about it. We need to train ourselves, too. Let's do push-ups. Head to Route 3. You know what that means, Paul. An opportunity for another Pokemon. Let's get out of here. This is how they replaced the HMs in this version, Paul. I can fly by just selecting a place on the town map, and I will be taken there. But you have to go there on your legs the first time. So now I was advised that I get challenged after coming out of here, but I'm okay with that, I think. I think I need the little challenge here. But just to be safe, let's make sure we have some good level Pokemon here. Let's go ahead and put Dahlia there, and we'll do Serpec and Dahlia. I should be accosted here shortly by an interviewer. Tickets here. That was Sun and Moon. I had you carried around by the Machamp. I mean, they had other ones as well, but the Machamp is definitely the one that sticks out. Like, you could ride Rhyhorn. That was pretty cool. I'm hoping to see that again in future games. You look like you got something you want to give to me. Nope. What about you? Uh-oh. You about to challenge me? Yeah, of course he is. Alright, Hop, I will embarrass you again. Wooloo, more like boo hoo, you lose again. Can't miss. Weakening the effectiveness of my Swift, I see. I like to think about how great the music is in the Pokemon games, and in a lot of games, like a lot of JRPGs in general. You spend so much time in battles listening to the same music over and over and over again, and somehow it doesn't end up being grating to me. Oh, you sneak. Not that I wouldn't have done that, but... Look at those level ups. You'll love to see it. Sly should be getting most leveling here soon, too. I mean, to evolve it. Here comes Score Bunny. Let's switch out. Bring in Martini. We're gonna absolutely wreck this Score Bunny. Score Bunny's gonna need that band-aid on his face. One shot, one kill. You should have known I'd master type matchups. This is the third time you've referenced my mastery of type matchups. There it is again. Answer pack leveled. Love it. You got any more Pokemon? Oh, that's right, you got a Rookie D. Yeah, let's switch out. And we're gonna go with Admiral Akbar. If the name doesn't give it away, Pop, it's a trap. Hit him with the rock tune. Bonus. Good hit, good hit. You don't mess with the Admiral. Dahlia wants to learn the rock. I mean, even a base hit of 60 is good, so... Yeah, we'll swap it for, I mean, lots of people got three ones, but I did set it up that you can do more than one name. Yes, we were going to forget. Yeah, forget rounds. I can't believe I didn't level up, or didn't evolve anybody yet, other than Martini. I can't remember what level Rookie D does, but it's gotta be like 15, 16, so it's gotta be 16 now. You ain't winning nothing, huh? You joke. Absolute joker, hop. You'll see a rare Pokemon at Wedgehurst Station. Where is that? Wedgehurst Station all the way back here? No, that's... Where the heck is Wedgehurst Station? It's Turfield. Holberry. And I'd have to go all the way back there. And then takes having to run through. I guess I can fly back later. Let's fly to Wedgehurst real quick. Taking the flying cab. Ow. Let's go see what this rare Pokemon's all about. Mando, hey buddy. Can you come up here? Mando? The train from the Isle of Armor has arrived. Ooh, got a sound effect. What happened? Ah! Dustin is hosting me, thank you. Drop them Mandos in stream. For my cuddly little boy here. That's not a bad idea, Dustin, since you're in here all the time anyways. Let me do that. I'm gonna make you a mod. Here's my community. There we go. Roles manager. Add new. D. Danger. Danger 10. There it is. Getting off, Mando? There you go, buddy. You should be a mod now. Oh, good idea tweeting that out, buddy. I forgot all about it. Alright, so he's still a water type. So, we'll go ahead and keep Sir Peck going. It makes sense for you to be a mod. You're my co-host on the podcast. Yeah, I saw. Thank you. I think I could probably catch it for you. Wild Slowpoke. Just hanging out on the train track. And now he's too nervous to eat berries. Okay. Hit him with a Swift. Be careful. Now, don't you make me sleepy. Okay, cool. Oh, the mods don't get emotes? See if this is good enough to catch him. I guess they assume the mods will be subscribers. Got him! Okay, so now if you've got channel points, it's 750 channel points, and you get to purchase the name. You get to purchase the name for my new Pokemon here. Okay, well, yes, we would like to give Slowpoke a nickname, because we have to, by law. There it is. I'm going to have a male Slowpoke named Hillary. Them's the rules. You did want two L's in Hillary. Here we go. Let's see. Let's take a look at Hillary's summary. Oh, that's right. He's psychic. Not psychic. Not water at all. Okay. So he's got acid. That's good. Confusion's good. Yawn is helpful for catching Pokemon. I might actually add Hillary to the party. Let's take a look at who else we got. So I don't really need two psychic types, but Admiral Akbar has been very helpful and is also ground type, which is helpful. I love Eevee, so I have to keep him in the party. I'm not entirely sold on Sly, if I'm being perfectly honest, but I know that Feeble will be at least decent with, as a dark type. I'll have some versatility there. What do y'all think? Anybody in chat have a suggestion that I should swap out Hillary for? You have a lot of normal type coverage, but eventually the child will be something. Actually, he's a Dynamax Eevee. I might actually keep him Eevee. No, I'm gonna stick with my current team. Sticking with the current team. We are not booting Eevee, Dustin. Have to keep Eevee in the team whenever Dustin is in stream because he's so anti-Eevee. Okay, you agree, Paul? I should swap Sly out? I mean, Sly did almost die in that one battle. No, no, stick around, Dustin. Stick around. We're putting Hillary on the team. We're moving Sly. Well, hey, man, I appreciate you hosting and stopping in the chat for a while. If I'm on when you're done with dinner, feel free to come back. So the only reason I'm considering Sly in the first place is because it's dark type. And, you know, I already have a psychic type right now. And Team Yell is going to use a lot, but they're gonna use dark types all the time. So P. Diddy's already level 20, so maybe I should. No, he's the Galarian Slowpoke is only psychic. Galarian Slowpoke. So. Yeah, I don't know. I just think that the typing is going to be better by having a dark type. That's true. Still beefy. I'm going to check real quick what Galarian Slowpoke... Slowbro? What his typings are. Oh, Oh, actually, Glaring Slowking might be the way to go. Yeah, because he's Poison Psychic. That's a pretty good combo. Okay, yeah, I'm swapping out. We're going to put Hillary in the game in place of Sly. And then I'm also going to see if I have any experience items that I can use on... Yes, I do. Okay. Boom. They have these experience candies in Sword and Shield, if you haven't played it before, that you can use. It's sort of like a rare candy, except it doesn't automatically level you. It just gives you experience towards the level. And when you level, you still gain the normal benefits of leveling that you don't always get with, that you don't get with rare candies. So now my weakest is still 13s across the board. Give one more to Hillary. And let's give... Give one to the Admiral. And there's a way to increase how many I use of these, I thought. We're gonna level up the child. Oh, so close. One more will do. Heal. Here we go. You remember when Psychic was just the absolute best typing to have? That and Dragon were like all you needed. Oh, the good old days. Back to Modestoke. All right. It is time. Let us venture forth. Route 3. Okay, so there's a Zigzagoon. No, I don't want to fight you. Catch the Zigzagoon first. Oh, Glass Ray. Using a Vulpix, you fool. You clearly didn't watch the first part of my Nuzlocke, in which I laid waste to like 100 Vulpixes. You did not watch the first part of my Nuzlocke. It is available both on the recent Twitch streams as well as on the YouTube channel Pod-ket Monsters. Pod-ket Monsters. Like a podcast about pocket monsters. Pod-ket Monsters. Oof, that was a big hit. Yep, critical. Switch. Let's put Martini out there to finish the job. Your quick attack is more like a tickle. You are nothing to Martini. Just a ball of red fur. Ups in there. Akbar with the side beam. Of course you should forget an old move for side beam. Every time. Yeah. I like disable better than growl, especially if there's an attack that's going to do serious damage to me, I can disable it. Not to get hit by it once, but it could be worth it. Take that, Ray. Need to heal up Sir Peck. Zigzagoon. We'll never eat berries again. Alright, we gotta catch this sucker. So, I don't want to do too much damage to it, so we're gonna peck. We gotta whittle it down without killing it. See, this is good enough. We're still in these lower levels. Sometimes you get lucky on a Pokeball throw with that much health still left on him. Got him. Boom. Zigzagoon. Now, in any other version of Pokemon, Zigzagoon, no big deal. This one, Galarian Zigzagoon, has a third evolution. So, could actually be someone you use long-term in a game. Okay, anybody want to purchase a name for this Zigzagoon using your channel points? What is it? What do they mean, out of stock? That's not right. Give me one second, Paul. I'm going to fix that. Okay. There we go. Okay, try again, Paul. But Paul, you have to name it now. Oh, there it is. Okay. Ah, ZZ Top. Excellent. Or as they say in England, ZZ Top. It looks better with the no space between the Z's. There we go. Send him to the box. We might use him later, but we just put Hillary on the squad, so we're gonna roll like this for a little while. Alright, but we're gonna train up a little bit. These guys are too close to my level. Go for moves that don't do damage as often, but Sand Attack is one that I just love using. Hit him with it a couple of times at the start of the combat. That's usually enough to ensure victory. That's gonna hurt that. Got me feeling down. No! Don't sing! What an awful thing to do. Don't sing. Make me use awakenings. What a waste. This Gossifer is being a real jerk. Finish him. Fatality. Okay. Let's go for another. Sand attack. You loser. Avoided it again. This is one I hope. Yes. Oh, okay, good. Just to finish the job. Sir Peck wants to learn Pluck. Sure thing, Sir Peck. And then, of course, a Tyrogue shows up. Hang on. Before I fight this Tyrogue, let's go ahead and get Sir Peck back in position so he can mess him up. You're going to mess up this Tyrogue with just one pluck. Welcome back, Paul. Helping hand. You don't even have a teammate. You silly Tyro. Let's get the child here up to level 15, and then we will go attack that next trainer battle. Big hit. That'll do it. Another Gossifleur bites the dust. We gotta kill one more. Jump right to the Swift. I'm not gonna make it past two anyways. Taking hits. I want there to be so much sand in this Zigzagoon's eyes that it can't even leer at us. Probably should have just done that from the start. All right. child is level 15. Wants to learn baby doll eyes. We had a copyright issue with one of our episodes, and it's still there. I'm having trouble getting it to eat. Like, you know, it's supposed to be like as soon as you're done, like as soon as you get a copyright claim against it, you're supposed to be able to just like remove the copyrighted part. And I have trimmed out the segment that they said needed to be trimmed out multiple times. And I just can't get it to do it. It's supposed to just trim it, and then it's supposed to be all better. We'll try it one more time. Okay. Well, I'm just going to keep playing. Forget all that noise. The user stares at the target with its baby doll eyes, which lowers the target's attack stat. This move always goes first, so that is better than Growl. Leveled up. We knew that was happening. Learn the baby doll eyes. I will heal the child, and we're going to go do trainer battle. Start this fight. Let's open up with Hillary. Our good boy Hillary. Fight me, child! Four languages, computers, and Pokemon. I studied two of those three things. Technically, I did study a foreign language, too. But of all the French I learned, the only thing I remember how to say is je ne parle pas français, which means I don't speak French. All right, Pancham. Get confused, son. You tackle me? You tackle me? School girl Hannah. That wasn't nothing. Do to him. should fall asleep now, which is good. I have disabled his snarl. That is just not very much damage. Now he's using sand attack on me. I might have to spot Pokemon. Swapping out. Sand attack is less fun when you're on the receiving end. But it doesn't matter when you've got Swift. Let's get Hillary out of there. There's too many dark types in the area. We'll try Dahlia. You to hit me. No physical attacks, Gossifleur. That's when you get caught and down. Same old mistake. There's your special defense. No speed. My bad. This Gossifleur is going to be so slow at the end of this. There we go. Is it worth healing? Yeah, probably. Rubbish. Let's see what this was. Ah, it's a pan sham. I always think that pan sham is like part grass type, just because of the little leaf in his mouth. He's not. Not even a little bit graceful. Martini, level 18. What a guy. Good guy, Martini. Yeah, okay, turn around. Oh, just have to check out from me. Dumb kid. Schoolboy Marvin. Where are your parents? He's out walking around and the woods by yourself. Oh, not the woods, but you know, the wilderness. Okay, that's a butter. So let's just hit him with the round. Ooh, no, don't let the door. I guess it is against a grass type, so that's not gonna be too bad. Stop healing yourself with my life force. Not okay. That'll do it. Yes, SpongeBob reference. I kept doing the move round, and it made me think around, and that made me think of that episode of SpongeBob. Stop on your left foot. Don't forget it. And I never did. I wasn't paying attention. Let's see who says he's up there. Oh, sending out gossip lore. Oh, I can. I'll switch both. Probably something better. Better suited to dealing with gossip lore. Get bucked. Oh, almost got him all at once. That would have been nice. Level ups. Thank you, Schoolboy Marvin, for providing me with experience fodder. And for your $720. Thank you. I will spend it more wisely than you. Sonia, what are you doing here? I looked real ace. I went a different way. The wrong way. The way they started talking about this building, like, I was like, oh, this is gonna be some huge building. Nope. Just a tiny little building. Pretty brilliant guy. Pretty brilliant guy, the chairman. Nothing but respect for the fella. Thank you for the escape rope. Escape ropes are probably actually pretty useful in Nuzlocke. So I'm definitely going to want... First, I'll save here. Gonna want a roly-coly as soon as I enter the next part here. When I get into the Galar mine, I'm going to go for a roly-coly. In the meantime, Martini will just mess one up. Yeah, it evolves into one of my favorite, actually two of my favorite designed Pokemon of the generation. Carcoal and then Colossal. Well, let's kill another one real quick with them. Probably don't even have to spend a water pulse on this guy. Congratulations, Admiral Akbar. I was really hoping that I would level up Serpeck at least on this. I feel like that'd be a good way to capture that. I think that's what I'm gonna do. We're gonna get Serpeck evolved. It's just so easy to just like take Martini and wail on these roly-colies and get the experience for it. Oh. Martini, you didn't have to go that hard, but you did, and I respect you for it. Mr. Postman. Postman Tad. Oh, Jelly Bird. Honestly, did not expect to kill him in one shot. I'm not going to be mad about it. Huh? Save your progress. Right, let's go see what this girl's up to. Thank you for the berry. Oh, she gave me a cherry berry. Martini's mooning the camera. Oh, Becca has a Yampers. Well, these are all her Pokemon, I guess. And Martini. It's her Pokemon and Martini. Man, I wish you were mine. You're a good looking dog. Really. We got Martini's going after. Here he comes. Here comes Martini. His tongue, or did he headbutt me? What was that? It's a tongue shot. Wow. Let's cook. I want to cook. Let's do it. I will cook with Becca. Let's do a cherry berry. And she gave me one. They're spicy hot. Tomato berry. We're gonna go spicy as all get out. Come on, you gotta fan faster than that. Becca, are you even stirring? I mean, for real. Spicy burger steak curry. I mean, I'd eat it. Man, another Wobbuffet class. Weak. Alright, let's get out of here. Martini wants a really tearful look. Nope, it's better than Growl. Depending on how many Pokemon this kid has, this could be the time that Sir Peck evolves. Paul, this is one of my favorites as well. I have a lot of favorites in this generation. Sizzilipede. His final evolution, really cool. Scent Scorch. But he is a fire type and a bug type. So Martini is his absolute worst nightmare. I think that Sizzilipede looks like a strip of bacon. Come on, have another Pokemon. I forgot, did you only have the one? Sending out a Dottler, huh? Oh, that's right, this one's an electric type. That's a mistake. Have a nice day. Couple more to get Serpec. One more level. Unless I can get a nice high level Rolycoly that I don't kill just in one shot. Let's see. I'm not hopeful for the Rolycolys. Yeah, this last one's gonna do it. Get this stuff. Yeah, super potion. I love to see it. Love to see super potion in another game. Always a welcome gift. Go. There it is. Finally, Sir Peck goes from page to squire. Literally, for the squire. The level up I wanted to get here. This feels like a good place to stop for the night. So, thank you for watching. If you haven't already, please follow or subscribe. Really would appreciate it. And then, as I mentioned earlier in the stream, also you can subscribe to myself and my friend Dustin's podcast, Pod-ket Monsters. Subscribe to us on YouTube, subscribe to us on Spotify, on Apple Podcasts. Well, you know, we're all over the place. If you're a Pokemon fan, we've got a lot of good content. Although I am still working on getting our most recent episode to be approved by YouTube, because it turns out by sharing video of the Post Malone virtual Pokemon concert, a very small portion of it, about 4 minutes, resulted in us getting a copyright block. And even though I've tried to remove that segment many, many times, YouTube continues to punish me for it. So who knows if that episode will ever be on YouTube. But the audio is available elsewhere, and the recording of it is still on Twitch as well. So there's that. So thank you, anyways, for watching. And we'll see you next time. I should be streaming part 3 here of my Nuzlocke. Possibly Wednesday night would be the next time. If not, we're looking at Thursday. So keep your eyes peeled. Follow me on Twitter if you want to be notified when I'm going live, in addition to the notification you probably will get from Twitch.